you know. Now I was in France during the war. I ended up getting a place to live in. A house up in Normandy while all the others went and fought.
Were you high ranking or something?
No. I was nothing. Just broke my legs, couldn't walk anymore.
At least you were alive.
You know, eventually, when you keep hearing news of your friends dying, not being able to hear or see, you eventually wish you were dead as well. And that old house.
How old are you?
21. Went into the service when I was 17. That was in 1943. Made it a week past D-Day, then I got hit fighting the Bocage.
Were you discharged?
Kind of. You couldn't get discharged where I was, but they put me in a house with some colonel.
Why was the colonel there?
That's punishment.
You take milk with it?
No.
Lost count a long time ago. Tell me wrong, have you ever killed somebody?
Like in the war?
Yes.
No, I guess it never came to that for me.
Now how is that?
You know, I don't know, I guess. I guess.
I have. I saw a soldier in my sights, and I shot. I had a duty to serve my country. I don't regret anything. I've known the people I've killed. It was either me or them.
I suppose.
One day, they're gonna drag us out of this house.
Hopefully when the war is over.
Do you think you'll ever see home again?
Sure I do.
I begin to feel at home. Here. I think that me and you should begin to accept that maybe this is our home now.
His insanity caused him to believe in the supernatural, ghosts and such. Every time the wind blew, he thought an exorcism was needed.
I suppose war does that to you.
Things he did wasn't normal, though. He wasn't normal.
Do you believe in ghosts, Ron?
No.
I used to be like you.
Oh, yeah.
When I was a kid, I had a best friend named Gunnar. Me and Gunnar would spend every day together. We could talk for hours about anything. The only problem that ever arose between me and Gunnar was that Gunnar had a third friend, and I never, ever saw Gunnar's other friend. Now, one day, Gunnar was particularly sad, and as any good friend would do, I asked him why. Listen to me. Listen. Now, this perplexed me, really did. And what made it even more confusing was that Gunnar told me that it was because of my parents. You see, Gunnar had this plan that all three of us would unite and become friends together. Now, this was a great idea. But when I asked my parents if Gunnar's other friend could come over, they said that he couldn't and that it wouldn't work.
So what?
From that day on, I hated my parents. I hated them. And it got worse, especially when they told me Gunnar wasn't real. I fought with my parents for a long time. And eventually they became fed up with me and they sent me off to my uncle's military academy.
Shit, sir. I'm sorry.
One day, Gunnar, you may find me again. You hear me?
What?
Do you want something to drink? Is milk okay?
Sure. Yeah.
Thank you.
I like it here. It's nice not having to be surrounded by the brutality of war all the time.
Doesn't that make you feel guilty?
Why feel guilty about something you can't control?
You see anything out there?
No, nothing. I found a bulb. I can't see it.
Maybe the wind is just heavy today.
I haven't heard any wind, Ron.
Could you just quiet it down?
I doubt it. It's there! It's there! I'm telling you, it's there!
God damn it, give it up! There's nothing to that noise!
There are spirits in this house, Ron! There are spirits!
Don't call me Ron. You goddamn lunatic.
Make me, cripple.
Fucking insane!
Big boy from the company B,
How's the colonel? Unbearable.
Is it truly that bad?
Sir, I need a transfer.
You know I can't do that. I need someone to watch over him.
Can I at least have a wheelchair?
Wheelchairs are for soldiers at the front.
You can't spare one wheelchair. I need just as much as the next guy.
Respectfully, sir, you're not still inside of a danger zone. If you truly need assistance, I can send a soldier to live with you and the colonel. I must warn you, however, that this soldier will also be incapacitated to a degree. You can't spare a perfectly healthy soldier here.
You know, it kind of makes me feel like some kind of freak.
Well, I do apologize for your service-related injuries. I do not apologize for the fact that you're particularly lucky to be here. In the midst of a brutal war, you've not seen the half of it.
Do you know what goes on inside this house? I'm going fucking insane. I don't know if this guy has schizophrenia or something, but he thinks there's fucking spirits in the house.
You know why you sent him here, right?
Eventually, I began to walk better. I still needed the crutches, but I could walk better. Thank you, again, for letting me stay here while I'm on my trip. At first, I was on one of the busier roads, and a nice lady picked me up. We got to talking, and she started to thank me for winning the war, for liberating Europe. I just sat there and smiled. Couldn't bring myself to say that. I'd sat it out. I never pulled the trigger on my rifle. Put the lighter down!
Sorry.
He's in the attic.
Okay.
We need to do something, Ron.
Don't call me Ron.
We can't kill him.
Okay.
I'm going.
If you see something, scream.
We can't let him know that we're looking for him. I see a violin. That's the code word. If I say it, I'll say it very calmly, like I don't see anything.
Okay. I don't see anything, Ron.
You've only been up there a minute. Keep looking.
This attic isn't very large, Ron. I'm looking everywhere.
You see anything yet? Tom?
He's playing the violin. The violin.
You didn't see any damn ghosts up there. What was it?
I don't know what to tell you, Ron. I saw it behind the boxes.
Stop fucking with me.
Gunner is in the attic, Ron.
There isn't a ghost.
Yes, there is! Open your eyes.
Do you want something to eat?
Sure.
I guess you had to go into the attic yourself?
That would have been nice.
Yeah.
Yeah, that would have been nice. Could you give me another glass? Tom, can you get that? Come on, Tom, get the door. Tom, get the door! Tom, get the fucking door! We must live with that now.
Your wheelchair is probably on its way now. Open your eyes and realize that we're not gonna get out of here, Ronnie. Do you see it? We're never leaving this place.
You shouldn't have talked to the inspector.
It's too late.
You had to know things weren't always going to be perfect here. You know, when I saw the inspector...
Just shut up, Gunner. Shut up.
What did you say?
Don't talk to me right now, Ron. It's not the time.
If you don't gather your thoughts, we are going to rot here.
It's not wise to say that, Gunner.
Listen to me, Tom.
Okay, Gunner. Okay.
Listen to me.
I wouldn't do that.
I know what you did, Tom.
You know why they sent him here, right?
You're guilty. I know you are.
Committed war crimes. Terrible ones. Worse than you can imagine.
I know you killed your own men.
These men, they trusted him.
They were our brothers. How could you kill them? What the fuck is wrong with you?
Tom was past saving. There's nothing I could do.
It sounds like you caused it.
What?
It sounds like you caused it.
Don't say that. Don't say that. He was mad. He was a hard person. There was bound to be conflict in that house.
Do you really think so?
Of course I think so.
It just seems like you were fighting for no reason. Like, you just couldn't get over yourself.
Don't fucking say that!
Can't possibly mean to tell me that things will be okay, Gunner. Things would be okay. Things would be okay. Ah, new record. Let's put it in.
I never found out what was down there in the basement.
Tom knocked me out, and when I woke up, I was in a camp. Apparently, the inspector had found me, but I knew nothing of that.
Who do you blame?
I'm sorry.
For what happened to you? For what happened in that house?
Look. It's not complicated. They send you straight into their mess. They expect you to fix their problem. And you go along with it at first. Because you feel like you owe it to somebody to fight. But then you begin to feel trapped. Like you're a hostage. And you don't know where to go. And the war's driving you insane. And it scares you. It changes you. It makes you angry. And he makes you lose your fucking mind. Until you do something terrible. Fractured life. The blood dripping through your hands. And as you inch closer to the end, look you straight in your eyes. And they say,
good job, soldier!